Hey folks, welcome back to Let's Play Grand Theft Auto 5 on the Mysterious JG. And for some reason, I guess I'm blaming a mental path I went down upon being given a save the money from the theater cash register, and that went poorly, and it just put me on this down this road of doing pointless, well, not pointless. We have to do them to get a Strangers and Freaks mission for Franklin. But we're going down the road of parachute jumps. Doing the marked official parachute jump challenge jumps in the game so that Franklin can reconnect with his good buddy, the Dominator. Dirty Dom, Dominic Mysterio. So I haven't been watching that much WWE. I had to stop watching AEW because it's just a fucking train wreck. But I'm not really watching WWE all that actively either. But I have heard that Dominic Mysterio is it's become a thing where it's not that he's really over as a heel that people hate him, but now like as an audience participation thing, when he tries to talk, you start booing loudly enough that he can't even be heard. So it's not even like people hate him. Although, I mean, he's a scumbag heel. He's like, betrayed his own dad. His whole thing is that, like, he talks, like, I guess he spent some time in juvie, so he talks about being a badass convict or what the fuck ever. He's in a sexual relationship with Rhea Ripley, except that in real life, it's one of those, wrestling is weird now because, it has evolved from this thing where a small percentage of fans know that it's, or fans believe it, and some fans knew that it was fake and still enjoyed it, to are predetermined. It's evolved into a thing where almost all fans know it's predetermined, but they jump back and forth between enjoying it as a performance and getting into the stories and believing them. And like fans who know that Rhea Ripley is in a romantic relationship with another wrestler from another company still play along that her on screen she's in a relationship with a wrestler from her own company and blah blah blah. What point was it getting at? I don't know that I had a point. But yeah, except that when Dominic Mysterio is on screen and starts talking, like the fans start booing louder than they do for anyone else to drown out anything he tries to say, but they don't actually hit him as a heel. That's just become part of the show, that's what you do, like throwing rice when they mention rice at or I guess there's like a wedding scene in Rocky Horror. I'm trying to remember, when do you throw rice? There's all sorts of odd, like cards. I guess people throw cards when he sings cards for trouble, cards for pain, cards for sorrow, cards. But yeah, it's like what I'm getting at is that booing Dominic Mysterio is like a Rocky Horror Picture Show audience participation thing. And why am I talking about it? Because there's a character in this game named Dom.
To myself.
Because we want to see one more thing with Dom. I'm desperate for more Dom content. Hey, we've got a. Oh, this is a shorter one at least. Whoa. Okay, didn't quite get that one right. But this one should. I don't know if I'll get it right on the second try. I don't know how many attempts it'll take. It's going to take a lot less time for each failed attempt. That's a thing. I'm digging on the placement of motorbikes and shit to like make it a little bit more palatable to just hurry up and finish, like get to the next one. After we complete one of these, we can get straight to the next one. And there's a real I didn't set out for this, but there's a real remember when everyone thought Idris Elba was going to be the next James Bond? And now Idris Elba in interviews is like, I'm not going to be the next James Bond. Like, at one point it got discussed, it never came together. I might be putting words in his mouth, but he said something to the effect of, I've got no, like, problem with James Bond. I don't hate James Bond, but I'm sick of being asked about it because it's not happening, and good luck to whoever gets it next, you know? But, yeah, Idris Elba would have been the first black James Bond, and that would have been cool and shit, but, like, dude going around wearing, like, a suit, not literally a tuxedo, but just a suit and parachuting is, and the fact that it's Franklin, who's black, y'all, that is kind of Idris Elba's James Bond. You know, I've got quite a few of these jumps left to do. I don't think I'm wrapping this up in this video, but I can taste the final Dom mission at this point. I'm pretty excited. And you know, I'm gonna, like, the idea of unlocking it and then not doing it right away is unlikely to happen. Although we need to also get with Trevor and pursue the bouncy storyline. He's already had sex with this person once that we did not see them. But, like, whatever the additional... the storyline is, like, this guy's got some hot chick who's in his employ somehow. And, Trevor is, doing murders, or doing jobs for some real estate guy for sex. Not with the real estate guy, though.
What up, dude? Get in. There's a train coming soon, and I have a wild idea, man.
This isn't Dom. This is like Dom's helicopter guy. Taking us on little mini Dom missions. Mini Dom missions. Mini Dom is the Lucha Libre Mini, who has his gimmick is that he's a miniature version of popular wrestler Dominic Mysterio. Yeah, understood. Runaway train never coming back. Okay, so the understanding the premise here. I have messed this up though. Yeah, I have messed this up. I don't think I can salvage this. Let's just retry rather than just dying. Okay, crashing into the side of the engine doesn't count. There's the G-Force theme. Okay. Any chance it's gonna... Nope. It's not going to catch up with me as I float overhead. Yeah, I think part of the problem there is I wasn't descending fast enough, so wait and jump a little later, or wait and pull the chute later. Okay. Yeah, that was a little too far down. Oh boy, I hit the square button, which is to jump. And luckily, that was not an exit command from that screen. Well, there's some kind of vehicle up on that. I think it's a vehicle. It might not be. I don't know how long the train is, but I probably need to... Fuck, I keep doing this. Yeah, not exactly super pro here. There's probably... I mean, there are dangerous stunt jumps like this in real life, but generally, like, if you don't have a good shot at doing it, you abort. Like, you just peel off to either side and do a safe splashdown on the mountain rather than just like, all right, I'm just going to fly right into the side of the bridge here. Okay, come on, get down. I don't know why I waited for him to die there. Like, I have the ability to hit the square button and spare him the pain. It's an Onion article once I'm being reminded of about, like, the incredible hell that Mario goes through. It's like, why won't the player just quit the game? Why must I die so many times? I think maybe I'm just, like, in too big of a hurry. I don't know how long the train is. There you go. 100% landing accuracy. $200 reward. That's all you get for this one. Okay, well, I guess I'm glad I did this one last, because there doesn't seem to be a quick way to get out of it. Let's try to get to this one next. We've done most of the... There's a whole bunch in a row over here. Let's try to get to this one next. I don't know what'll be the simplest way to get off of this train. You know, you don't really want to hop off of the train at this point and have, like, this length of tunnel to run through. Like, I used to get, like, not anxiety exactly, but I used to, I would have to drive through a tunnel on the way to work, or on the, actually, it was on the way to grad school, and this is a car tunnel, not a train tunnel, but it was a similar, like, there would be room for a person to walk along, obviously for maintenance, but it was a scary, kind of a scary thought to me, like being stuck. It's similar, I have nightmares occasionally about what if your car broke down or crashed or something and you were on a long automobile bridge and you had to, like, try to walk your way off of the bridge without getting run over or... What is going on with the lighting here? What kind of fucking disco effect going on there? But yeah, like, that's kind of a scary thought, like being stuck in a tunnel and having to walk, like, a big long walk to the end where you're just, like, pressing up against the wall so that if somebody who's, like, speeding along and not paying attention won't, like, fucking kill you. Because in real life, if they're doing maintenance in a tunnel like that, they're going to close an entire lane. They're not, like, exposing workers to that kind of danger. Anyway. Your wife earns more Pilates than you do. Or more money. You're not more. Your wife earns more Pilates than you do. Sorry. No, I can't be bothered to stop the thief because, last time I tried to break up a crime, rather my friend Michael did, he ended up driving all across the state and it just distracted us from doing main story missions. Homie. Show your life who the family tool is. You say location in Fallout New Vegas called, like, HHH Hardware, and I know that because it kept being in a loading screen, even though I never... Like, I think I even found it and never bothered to go inside because there was no story reason to do so. But I just remembered it being in the loading screens forever. HHH Hardware. Alright. I'm just trying to get to whatever you guys think is a road here, because none of this feels like road to me. At least none of what I'm on now. Fuck it. Just get out and walk. Jeez. We came out here. This is the... Why won't he run? Run! Is it because of his shoes? It's got to be. He's probably wearing some kind of anti-Bo Jackson shoes. They prevent him from... Cross training. There we go. Something was going on there. He was not running. Oh, look, there's a setup probably for a stunt jump. Huzzah. I guess it's the sand. It looks like the sand has special. And that's a little thing. Like, yeah, somebody had to program that, and it doesn't come up in the game very much, but they have a little thing where there's a mechanic with running in sand. Damn you, Grimmoth's chat. How could you not recognize the brilliance of the sand? Mechanic. Anyway, here's the... Okay, be careful not to accidentally jack this helicopter like Michael did.
Franklin, you really got the bug now, huh? I got two words for you. Mount Chiliad. Man against mountain. What do you say?
Well, Mount Chiliad's two words, but whatever. Let's do it. Oh, man, it's no. I gotta get another 1,500 steps in today. I'm doing video games about extreme sports, so that makes me an extreme sports guy who still doesn't have 10,000 steps today. It is a long way from Chamberlain Hills, you're right. All right, sail through the checkpoints. It's going to be one of those long ones, but maybe I'll be able to clear it a little faster than... Well, that was kind of weird. Like, he actually... The helicopter takes us to a place where we just... Do a base jump rather than a helicopter jump. You would think they would make you drive to Mount Chiliad to do this, which I'm fine that they didn't, but. Alright, let's try to get lined up with the checkpoints. Oh, I can see where we're landing too. This. Alright, I don't. Watch me mess this up now, but this one shouldn't be too bad. Because I can see where we're landing with lots of time. There's no, there's nothing forcing you to take, like, a sudden turn in any direction. This one shouldn't be too bad. Other than the fact that I just whacked the shit out of us, but we actually beat it, at least. So that's fine. No helicopter here for us to... Wait, what was that message? Approach helicopter and press to start parachuting. Oh, well, that's nice. So we do actually have the helicopter here that I can just jack... That's kind of rude, because I thought he was our friend, but... Oh, he's like that cop from Vice City, except not quite as powerful, because he tried really hard to get us there, but I just kept descending. Remember that we had the super cop from Vice City who just, like, grabbed the door of the helicopter as it was taking off, like, bodily slammed the helicopter back down and got us out of there? Yeah. So with Franklin, I probably should steal this helicopter and go get us a helicopter. That would be the smart play, but right now I'm like, I know where I can go get one now. I know anytime I go to this check that jump, I can steal a helicopter. And the Frogger's fine. It's a nice, reasonably speedy helicopter. It doesn't have weapons. We don't need weapons on the helicopters. But we can use it to do... we can use it to... Have a helicopter available for Franklin if he ever needs one. The only other place I even had a vague notion we could steal a helicopter for Franklin was if we kept stealing the Trevor Phillips Industries one, and I would think that that would be a problem for Trevor. But at this point, I just was like, yeah, let's just use a helicopter as a fairly quick way to get to this other jump. Field is a fairly safe place to quasi crash land a helicopter. Let's see what's going on here. We're making good progress on these jumps now because we had that one that took like 7 tries and each one was multiple minutes per try, but since that time we're making good time. I don't know what's going on with this. But I am curious to check it out. This is Officer Lewis. Suspect apprehended and requested backup. Over. Move along, sir. This is police business. I think we want to probably take the cop out. Three star? Oh, fuck. I didn't think I'd get 3 stars. I thought maybe something would happen where we'd get a reward for helping the fellow criminal, but instead, looks like we're just going to get murdered by cops. Now, in fairness, I, like, entered into a game scenario. I was like, you know what I'll do? I'll pull out a shotgun and shoot a cop. So I can't complain too much about what's happening here, but... This does not count as having evaded the cops. Gonna need to get a real car or something. Yeah, I don't think stopping to shoot down the helicopter will help too much. But this might work out. I didn't mean to hit that. I was trying to shut off the lights. So this didn't really help with getting our, oh shoot, I ran right towards where the police were pursuing me from. What the hell? I didn't turn at all. Is the car supposed to be damaged? Yeah, I'm not sure what happened to get my car turned around that way. Did my wheels get... Yeah, one of my rims got shot out. That's part of the problem. And I tried to activate my superpower, and it didn't work there. Yeah, I'm riding on the rims in a stolen cop car. Usually this means you've made bad decisions in life. Trevor, help me! good place to turn, friend. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Evade that cone. There we go. It's a nice feeling to evade a 3-star wanted level, which I'm about to do, I hope. But I was kind of hoping to get some kind of reward for stopping to help that fellow criminal. And actually, we kind of didn't. Oh, well. Yeah, we ran into a completely different, unrelated situation. Let's go ahead and take a cab to the next jump.
Any cabs available?
Not a problem. A driver's on the way.
I'll be here.
Look for the guy's been shot a whole bunch. Near the wreckage of a police vehicle he clearly stole. Apologies in advance if I accidentally jacked the vehicle. Okay, I did stop to read and confirm my understanding of the controls.
Grape seed.
Good thing, man.
We're already in grape seed. What the fuck? Says the driver. We probably shouldn't talk like that because it works for us. You know what I don't like about this game is the fact that our taxi cab is not driven by George Lucas. That is a problem.
Who's trying to out-dominate the Dominator? I am taking you up to knock on heaven's door.
All right, I appreciate that, man. I apologize about jacking your last copter. Although this is a different copter from the... I mean, it's a different guy who flies the Frogger from this guy. I don't know. Follow the Alamo. Alright, well, we'll see how tough this one is, but it will definitely be how we wrap up this video, and for those watching as they first go public, this will be how we wrap up the weekend. Because I just got on a parachute thing here. We're going to end up landing on Mount Chiliad? I kind of hope not. We're obviously too low to land on the peak now, but... I think I obviously had to turn to do this one, right? Yeah, I think I might be too low to get the rest of these checkpoints. I'm trying to get as much height as I can. I was pressing down. I guess that arrow is supposed to be pointing backwards behind me as opposed to down. I did the steep dive, which was not the correct move, although this might count. Yeah. All right, so we're closing in on the end of these parachute jumps, too. I think we've done more than half of them, I think, in the last couple of videos. There's 13 total. We did at least four along that one river area. We've done 5, 6, 7. Yeah, I think we've done more than half of them in these last couple of videos. And we've done a few before that. We've got to be closing in on being done with them. Don't know if we'll finish them up next time because I am planning to call it a session here. And maybe next week I'll be like, I'm really sorry we didn't get any story accomplished last time. And jump into story. But kind of got the freedom. Ow. Barely survived, but passed the mission. Kind of made a mess of that last landing, but see, we got this one. Let's see. Done. Not done. 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 Not done. I think we got like four left. All right, let's start with one. Okay, not done. Not done. Not done. Done. Not done. 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 Not done. Done. So we got five left. Let's hope Michael's near his house so he can save. Maybe he's even in his house watching TV. That would be ideal. Dear, we hope. Oh. Oh, thank you, game. Not watching TV. Even better. He's in bed, which is where he needs to be for us to save. This is ideal. This is exactly what we needed to wrap this thing up. All right, guys. So, if you watch these as they go up, and you just had to sit through 2.5 videos of parachuting. Really, 2 videos of parachuting and 1 video of Michael chasing around people who robbed a cash register. And then failing to even attempt a parachute jump because he accidentally hijacked a helicopter. And then buying a garage. And then landing on top of a building and parachute jumping down, but it not counting. Followed by 2 videos worth of parachute jumping. All I can do is say, I'm sorry. When we come back next time, I don't know if I'll finish the parachute jumps in one go or if we'll switch to something else, but I don't know. It's I think I warned you guys at the top. It's a GTA game, pretty free form and chill. Wasn't necessarily going to be the most efficiently, like it was not a GTA speedrun by any stretch. So if you like hanging out with JG doing random video game bullshit, it's a good series for you. If you want to see like get down to business, knuckle down and really like knock out a game, this, well, it's not your channel in general, and this is not the game to watch me try. Catch you next time.